Hi everyone, so today I'm going to be performing three different pieces, one on my clarinet and two on my saxophone. So the first piece I'm going to be performing today is Weber's Clarinet Concerto in F minor, and I'm going to be playing the third movement, Rondo. So Weber, he was a German composer and he wrote mainly clarinet concertos, operas and two symphonies. The concerto as a whole was written in 1811 and originally was written for an orchestra to accompany a solo clarinet, but now has been written for the clarinet to have a piano accompaniment. It was also written for a German virtuoso clarinetist called Heinrich Barman, and it's also probably one of the most highly regarded pieces in the clarinet's repertoire. So why I've decided to perform this today is, firstly, it's one of my favourite classical pieces to perform, and secondly, one thing that's always got brought up, whether I've done competitions or when I did this for my exam, and even like for my music college interviews, there's like the slow contrasting section, and I really feel within the piece it's good because it's not just I'm showing one side to my playing, I'm showing also maybe the expressive side to my playing as well, which I think is really important. So yeah, here we go. Hope you enjoy. Thank you. Okay, so the second piece I'm going to be performing is Scaramouche Suite for alto saxophone. I'm going to be playing the third movement from this, which is called Brasileira, and this is by Milhaud. Milhaud was a French composer and is probably one of the most significant composers in modern music. So this piece was originally written for two pianos, but now has been written for many different instruments to be accompanied by a piano. So Milhaud was in a group called Les Six, and these were called Impressionists. Now, basically what I mean by an Impressionist is through the music, they kind of like created like the atmosphere or like of something through like the event of something. So in this case, obviously was it called Brasileira, in the name Brazil. Brazil are known for having like carnivals and stuff. And I really feel what Milhaud's done is kind of created like the atmosphere of a carnival, like in the music, which I think is clever. So why I've decided to perform this today is, firstly, it's a very exciting piece to perform, and also I really feel it shows off the technical side to my playing, and it just uses like the whole range of the saxophone as well, which is good. So yeah, I hope you all enjoy. Piece I'm going to be performing today is Sonatina for alto saxophone and piano, and this is by James Ray. So I'm going to be performing two movements from this, the first one being Genoppa di Blu and the second one called East Coast Main Line. So a bit about James Ray. So he was an English composer and he's from Tyneside, and he studied clarinet, bass clarinet, piano and composition at Guildhall School of Music. The Sonatina was written in 2005 and performed by the famous saxophonist Paul Summers in London of that year. So a bit of background about like the second movement. which is Genopoly, which is the first one I'm going to be doing. It's a smoother piece and it's very expressive, and there's been a lot of influence by Erik Satie's Genopoly number one, which is played on piano. And then I'll move on to the third one, which is East Coast Main Line. And this piece is very upbeat, and there's a lot of Latin jazz influence within the piece. But the East Coast Main Line, I mean, I don't know if any of you know this, but the East Coast Main Line is a type of train, and basically it goes up like the East Coast of the UK. And it's a very fast train, and basically what James Ray does is, in the opening, there's like a semi-quaver run, and that kind of like represents almost the train and like it going, like fast and everything. So yeah, a bit like what Milhaud did with Brasileira, but yeah. So why I wanted to perform this today is, again, one of my favorite saxophone pieces, and I feel like it shows contrast between the two with Genopoly and East Coast. So yeah, I hope you enjoy. Thank you.